Hello, Gemini. Thank you for joining me for your year 2018 forecast. The big event which occurred towards the end of last year was the move of Saturn, shifting out of your seventh solar house, the sector of relationships, into your eighth, and that occurred on the 20th of December. So the big news as we storm into this new year is the amount of energy that is clustered in your eighth solar house. The eighth house is about change. It's about evolution. It's about our development as deep spiritual beings. Some things in 2018 may die out of your situation, but some new, very exciting prospects are going to be heading your way. And it really, really is that exciting. Not least because Mars and Jupiter are combining in a part of your scope at the turn of the year, which is very much to do with your physical vitality, your health, your ability to work hard, to be optimistic about your prospects in business and in employment. And this combination can really make you decisive in a way which can see other people sit up and take notice. But there's even more good news than that, because Venus, the planet of relationships, is also the planet of finance. This is less known. And in the latter part of this year, for an extended 12 and a half week period, there is going to be an extended duration of a transit by Venus through your eighth house too. So this can be very important for very close romantic bonds, even potentially sexual ones, and also if you want to be more entrepreneurial this year. And that's really where the story starts beyond Saturn, because at the very first day of this year, the Sun is clustered together with Venus. Now, when these are tightly bound together, it is said that Venus's luster can be diminuted a little bit. I don't agree with this. I think you're going to be showing huge passion throughout 2018. And the combination of these two is a real insight of why. But there's more than this, Gemini, because the two are also going to be angling up brilliantly to Neptune, which is all about your imagination, especially in a professional or worldly context. So if you are someone who wants to in some way guide or advise or climb the ladder of success when it comes to more formal employment, your mixture of your instincts but also your basic nous and go-getting energy are going to be something that can really, really have an impact. But also that combination with Mars and Jupiter is something I'm really excited about for you, because it's going to give you a lot more vitality. Saturn was really tough for you over the last 2.5 years as far as relationships are concerned. But I think by the end of 2017, the chances are that the person that you were with or the people that you're friendly with are the people who are really good for you. Because all the fly-by-nights have probably been squeezed out of your situation by Saturn's relentless inquisition. But now, of course, Saturn is going to ask you to be that much more disciplined about your resources and to make the most of your talents. But this unique set of energies at the start of this year does give you a wondrous opportunity. And this brings us up to the total lunar eclipse in Leo, which occurs on the 31st of January. This is a real opportunity to get in touch with how you think about things. You're the zodiac's most swift-footed communicator, and certainly over the next 6 months it's a chance for you to showcase this. But is there a catch? Well, there is, because this is linking in a quincunx with Neptune. Now, I've already told you Neptune can be very helpful to you in terms of you tapping into your imagination and also your instincts. But of course, your intellectual approach, if it's merged with too much instinct, could actually take the gloss off what needs to be more factual. So do bear that in mind. What's going to help you hugely, however, is that the partial solar eclipse, which occurs on the 15th of February and also provides a backdrop for the next 6 months, is much more intellectual, and it's going to give you a massive appetite to check out information and learn new things. Don't be surprised if you're on the move during this period of time. Overseas travel or just moving around more in your locality are huge possibilities, because this partial eclipse is combining with Mercury, your ruler. Knowledge, therefore, always very important, is going to really instruct some of your approaches and some of your moves. And that in itself is very exciting for you. But that takes us into April. And in the middle of April, Saturn does whack on the brakes, as it does each year, for 5.5 months. And through to the 6th of September, is tracking backwards around your joint resources in anything to do with long-term financial planning, business, and even intimacy. Now, you may have to work quite hard at these areas. Mind, at the end of April, as Mars and Pluto combine in the sign of Capricorn in the last 10 days, things can really fizz from a more sexual viewpoint if that's the kind of energy you want to bring to your situation. This could see you reinvigorate an existing relationship, or it could see the sparks fly. But on the other hand, it could, if you're single, see you much more seeking in terms of getting that closeness, that deep transformational closeness that comes from a very deep bond. And that's something that could be very much to the fore as April comes to a close. But mid-May sees a massive event. Uranus, the planet of change, which has been in a very revolutionary part of your scope full-time since 2011, is going to move into your 12th solar house. Now, it's going to be there through to the 5th of November. Now, on the 7th of August, it does start a retrograde. And in fact, by the 6th of November, it's going to switch back into to Aries, which for you has actually been very, very positive, because that's your future, it's your planning, it's your desire to be independent in terms of your friendships. It may have connected you to more unusual people over this period of time, but it moving into the 12th house is one which can be profoundly restlessness creating. The 12th house is about secrets. It's also about your deeper emotional psyche. And if there is anything in the very depths of your being which does need to come up and be aired to show just the authentic you, it's not saying that you've been lacking in sincerity at all. It's just about consciousness. So something could come up that happened way in your past history that you've actually perhaps looked at, maybe dusted down, got some air around it, tried to understand it a bit more, and you may feel it's not particularly active in terms of your decision making and south now. But you may be surprised during that period of time between mid-May and the early part of November. Try to take this in your stride, because next year, 2019, Uranus is going to come back for a much more extended stay in this part of your horoscope. So this is just a little bit of a taster of what's going to become a much bigger experience for you. And it's all about uncovering and getting deeper down inside of yourself. But as I said, it can be an exhilarating process, that's for sure. However, the 25th of April through to the 19th of May does see Venus, the planet of love, but also finance, making its way through your zodiac sign. But once it completes this process for the following 28 days, it could bring some financial fortune your way. And this could happen in the most unexpected of manners, which could absolutely delight you. Of course, I have told you about the importance of Venus in the last phase of this year, when it's going to go through that 12.5 week journey, a really big journey for you, because that can be so important in terms of how you fund or how you join together in terms of your absolute root existence. But of course, the second half of the year is going to be informed very much by eclipses, just like the ones that occurred in January and February. And the lunar eclipse, which occurs on the 27th, is very much about your desire to travel, your desire to be a free spirit, and also to engage in the kind of knowledge which really inspires you. And it certainly can do that. But the really exciting eclipse for you is the partial solar eclipse on the 11th of August, because that's combining with Venus in a beautiful location for you. And this could mean that a relationship can come into your situation in the last half of this year, or one that's been growing in importance can just put down even greater roots for you. It's very exciting stuff, but what's so important for you is the whole concept of communication. If you're not feeling that you're communicating well, that is not going to bring you closer to someone. So getting this level of intimacy with you feeling comfortable around just the ebb and flow, the everyday chit-chat, which you really love and bring so much fun and stimulation to in all your different interactions. That's going to be the challenge of this year in some ways. But the second half of the year is also coloured by the role of Jupiter. Now, Jupiter has been giving you plenty of support when it comes to the more practical side of life, and as I say, it's going to give you a lot of extra physical vitality throughout this year, not least from its combination with Mars at the turn of the year. However, Jupiter then moves into its home zone on the 11th of November, and if ever an opportunity was presented for you to really bring some good fortune to all sorts of relationships, it's going to be in that period through to the end of the year. So seize this chance, along with Venus, giving you the opportunity to think things over, be practical about the way you interact with people, understand where they're coming from, as well as being given from your viewpoint. But I think as you come to the end of 2018, not only will it have been a huge journey of discovery in terms of your talent and how you monetize it and how you feel secure in the world, but also how you get up close and personal to people, and particularly the people that really count. So a special, intense relationship is definitely in the works for you this year. It's been a real pleasure being with you. Thank you for joining me. Good luck in 2018, and goodbye. Thank you for joining me. If you'd like to know more, please visit my website at www.patrickarendall.com or download my free app in iOS, Google, or Facebook at www.horoscope-ace.com. Thanks and goodbye.